ओके यस या थैंक यू फॉर रिमाइंडिंग दैट वन वन डेरिवेशन वाज लेफ्ट नो आई विल डू इट टुडे डेफिनेटली आई विल डू इट यस रिशिता खदीजा सुफियान या फोर स्टूडेंट्स आर देयर आई डोंट नो व्हाई अदर्स हैव नॉट जॉइन बाय नाउ आई थिंक इट्स क्वाइट गेटिंग लेट एनी एग्जाम और समथिंग इज देयर कि मरियम हैज जॉइन थिंक इट्स टाइम मश ओके लेट मी वेट फॉर टू मोर मिनट्स बाय द टाइम यू ऑल राइट डाउन द क्वेश्चन And I'll discuss if students are still joining. 2 more minutes and I'll discuss it. Taha also joined. Taha has joined. Sufyan has joined. Sufyan was there. Mariam has joined. Okay, I think now most of you have joined. Yeah, so in the last class we were doing LCR circuit series, LCR circuit we were completing, and we have completed the theory part of it, and now we have to move to other types of circuits which are present. So in series LCR circuit, this is a question which is given that let us discuss this also. But before this, few things. Firstly, cameras. Do I need to remind it to all of you? Other students also, only Yahya obeys this. Even in if he has a one-to-one classes, he follows it there also. Please, other students, just make it a habit and have it arranged before this. Mariam, Khadija, Taha, please follow the instructions. Mariam, Khadija, Mariam, Siddiqua has Taha. No. Yeah, so we were discussing. Okay, Taha. So we were discussing LCR circuit. In the last class, we had discussed a term which is quality factor. Sufyan, can you just quickly revise it so that all of us can be briefed about it? About just Q factor. You can see your notes also. या सूफियान. व्हाट इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ क्यू
सुफिशियो
फैक्टर?
क्वालिटी फैक्टर
यस सूफियान, आई इवन अलाउड यू टू गो थ्रू योर नोट्स ऑल्सो, बट दिस शुड हैव बीन डन बिफोर द क्लास. क्यू फैक्टर स्टैंड्स फॉर यस सूफियान, आर यू एबल टू हियर मी सूफियान?
क्वेश्चन
Q factors full form you're not able to tell Sufyan, then how
क्वालिटी
will you? I thought you're going to make us revise the whole topic quickly. Quality
क्वालिटी
factor. What does it tell us?
इट टेल्स शार्पनेस ऑफ रेजोनेंस
It tells us sharpness of resonance. Q factor means the quality factor that tells us the sharpness of resonance. You can mute yourself, Sufyan. It tells us the sharpness of a resonance. If we have very low values of resistance, it means the highest amount of current is achieved. And if you have high amount of resistance, then it means low value of current is achieved. There was a graph also which we had plotted. Rishita, the formula for Q factor. We have done various formula, at least tell one of it.
मैम रूट ऑफ आर स्क्वायर प्लस डब्ल्यू एल माइनस 1/WC होल स्क्वायर इक्वल्स टू रूट टू आर
Which formula it's saying, Rishita? Root?
मैम क्यू इक्वल्स टू डब्ल्यू आर बाय W2 माइनस W1 दैट्स फाइन
That is one. What is W R here? What is W R in the formula? The formula you've mentioned is correct.
the width of the resistance, the resonant frequency, I think.
The resonant frequency, you have also not revised it. It clearly shows because you, why, how can you be so underconfident? And class, in this, I am allowing you to even see the notes, which I mentioned that I won't. Yeah, it's resonant frequency. And what is omega 2 minus omega 1, Rishita?
The
The
bandwidth.
bandwidth. Perfect. Omega R by omega 2 minus omega 1. So omega R is the resonant frequency, omega 2 minus omega 1 is the bandwidth. Okay, all of you should remember this. Yeah, one more formula for this. Q factor.
Omega 2 minus omega 1 is equals to 1 by LC.
So an elaborated version. Finally, we had a formula with L, C, and R. Class, this was the formula which Rishita mentioned, omega R by omega 2 minus omega 1. This is important. Secondly, this formula is very important, 1 by R under root L by C. Okay. Khadija, in the last test also, you have not followed the instruction. Please follow it. Other students are also obeying it. Q is equal to 1 by R under root L by C. This formula. Will you remember it now? Okay. These formulas are important. Now the question will be very easy if you look at this question. The question says, in series LCR circuit, the resonance frequency is 800 hertz, means omega R is equal to 800 hertz. Just pay attention here, class, because now I'm discussing it, so you can later try it by yourself or copy it. The half power points are obtained at frequencies. Half power point means The points which you were mentioning, Rishita, omega 2 and omega 1. Okay, so these are sometimes also called as half power points. Or they're mentioned as the points prior and next to the resonant frequencies. So it's very easy. Whenever you see two terms are there, two frequencies are given in a question of LCR circuit where you see resonance frequency and it's related to Q factor and bandwidth and all. Directly understand that one will be omega 2, one will be omega. Anyways, omega 2 is 855 hertz. Omega 1 is 745 hertz. Okay. So calculate the Q factor of the circuit and the bandwidth. Q is omega R by omega 2 minus 1. Now we do not have information about LCR. So we are going to use this formula only. So omega R is equal to 800 by 855 minus 745, which is equal to 800 by 110. So 7 point something, 7.27. And bandwidth, the second part, which is the bandwidth, is even easier. It is simply the lower part. 855 minus 745, which is 110. Okay, hertz, because it's the frequency. Write it, all of you. All have completed.
1 minute.
Yes, others apart from Sufyan and Yaya, all have done.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Rishita is also completed. Mariam is also completed. Taha done. Sidra? Yeah, please switch on the videos, rest of the students. And Khadija, just adjust your camera properly. Just Khadija and Rishita. Yeah, so the next circuit that we see, LCR circuit is over. Okay. So we have now short circuits. Now, since you have done the bigger LCR circuits, which is a combination of all the three together. Now smaller two circuits are there which we have to deal with, and now you will find it easy because one component will be deleted. So we'll start with LR circuit first. Series LR circuit. Sidra, unmute yourself, open the camera and answer. In case of circuits having only a resistor, which is leading? Current is leading or voltage is leading? Sidra. And meanwhile, Sidra is answering. Rest of you in the chat column answer. Like, you okay, fine, Sidra. If you're using your data, you cannot switch on the camera for today. For today, okay? From the next class, please try. And answer. At least answer you can do, Sidra. Answers you can give. For the just a circuit having only a resistor, which is leading, current and or voltage? Meanwhile, other students also reply. Good, Mariam and Yaya. Yes, Sidra, main is your answer. This question is for you. Other students have already attempted the questions before you join. Okay. According to you, voltage leads the current. And what is the angle, Sidra? If voltage is leading the current, there must be some angle with which it has led the current. And I'm talking about circuits having only resistors. Okay, Sidra, next question. In the circuits having only inductor, now which is leading, current or voltage? You're not sure. Why are you not sure? Conductor. Maybe conductor. Current and voltage were your options, Sidra. And you're choosing conductor. What is the issue, Sidra? Why are you not studying? Please answer this. Just text me in the chat column properly. Your issue, why are you not studying? You are irregular also with the classes. Assignments I cannot see. Some students are constantly submitting their assignments also. I'll show you the portal today. You tell me where is your assignment? Where is your homework? One or two questions you people are not able to handle. I think in the last class also two questions were given. No, one question was given. From this chapter, I have been giving only one questions because these days your exams are approaching. From the circuits having only resistor. Yeah, Sidra, you please type me the message. What is your reason? Why are you not studying? Are you not able to understand in the class? Are you not revising? You're understanding and you're not able to revise. You're able to understand theory and not able to do numericals, anything, please tell. So what is the syllabus, Sidra, in your physics exam, which is going on? Those are done properly. When is the exam? Still doing. When is the exam, Sidra? Tuesday 7th, because 6th is Monday, Yaya's exam. Sidra, Tuesday 7th? 7th October you have the exam? How much you have prepared? You just tell me that. So tell me how much is your preparation? I'm learning only theory and derivations as of now. Chapters, Sidra, some chapters might be completed. Okay, it's okay, you're not doing the numericals. I want the chapters so that your preparation can be done. This is not just, I'm not asking to scold you or taunt you or something. I'm just asking for your exams. Chapter 2 and 3 you're doing. Okay, Sidra, I'll talk to you later. Siddika? Yeah, Siddika, open the mic, open the camera, answer both the questions which I have asked to Sidra. इन द सर्किट हैविंग
करंट
ओनली रेजिस्टर विच इज लीडिंग, करंट और वोल्टेज? वोल्टेज एंड विथ विच एंगल? हाउ मच?
90 डिग्रीज,
90 डिग्री.
90
ओके.
डिग्री
एंड इफ वी हैव ओनली अ सर्किट हैविंग ओनली इफ वी हैव अ सर्किट हैविंग ओनली इंडक्टर, नाउ विच इज लीडिंग, करंट और वोल्टेज?
करंट करंट
विच इज लीडिंग?
करंट
करंट इज लीडिंग. एंड विथ वॉट एंगल?
180
ओके, सेम थिंग सिद्धिका. एंड व्हाई आर यू नॉट स्टडिंग? सेम थिंग, सेम रीजन. यू आर नॉट डूइंग न्यूमेरिकल्स, यू आर जस्ट फोकसिंग ऑन डेरिवेशन. यू हैव डन चैप्टर 2 एंड 3 ओनली एंड योर एग्जाम इज ऑन ट्यूजडे. नाउ एटलीस्ट आई सी यू आर रेगुलर विद द क्लासेस. अर्लियर यू वर इरेगुलर विद द क्लासेस सो आई कुड अंडरस्टैंड, बट रिसेंटली नाउ इट्स इट वॉज अ गुड थिंग दैट यू स्टार्टेड टेकिंग द क्लासेस प्रॉपरली. You are attentive also in the classes. Then what's the reason for not revising?
Ma'am, at the moment I have classes going on and I'm studying those chapters, the ones my teachers are teaching.
Okay, what are you studying? Which chapters? What about physics? Physics you study?
Yes, ma'am.
Which chapters you are doing?
Ma'am, next week I have it in magnetism.
What?
Sunday.
You have exam?
Magnetism. Not exam, just a class test on magnetism.
On magnetism. So magnetism is done properly. Are you at least revising that chapter?
Yes, ma'am, I'm revising it. I'm not done with it.
Okay. Taha, your second answer is already right. I want you to answer both the parts properly so that we at least get the answers right. I hope you'll answer both correctly.
Neither.
Yeah, first one, resistor.
And neither of them are leading or lagging.
Out of current and voltage, you're saying?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Taha?
So neither of them are leading.
Correct. Neither of them are leading. Other students, Siddhika, I had asked the question. They are in the same phase. And Taha, your second answer was already right in the chat column. Please complete that. In inductor circuit, what is there?
Voltage leads current by 90 degrees.
Correct. This is the exact answer. See, in a circuit having only resistors, see, without this, you'll not be able to answer questions. Current and voltage both are present, okay? Current is present, voltage is present. They are exactly in the same phase. None of them is leading the other quantity. They are exactly in the same phase, 0 degree, no angle between them. In circuits having only inductor, voltage leads the current by 90 degree. Voltage leads the current by 90 degree. And in the circuit having only capacitor, current will lead the voltage by 90 degree. This is, I think we have discussed it multiple times also. So in this, these are in the same phase, but here voltage is leading the current by 90 degree. Okay. So when you have the figure, remember when we were doing LCR circuit, at that time we had one component for capacitor also downwards. And I told you that whichever will be greater, that side we'll draw the direction as the way we draw for vectors. Right now the capacitor is not present. So only these two are there. Only these two are present. Correct. And in from the impedance triangle also, remember the derivation, we had started the derivation with the Pythagoras theorem that E naught square is equal to R square. Not R square, VR square plus VL minus VC or VC minus VL square. That was how we started the derivation for LCR circuit. Now capacitor is not there. So instead of VL minus VC, we just have VL square. So it's easier. One component is reduced. So this will ease your calculation, derivations and everything. So E नॉट स्क्वेयर इज आई नॉट आर करेंट इनटू रेजिस्टेंस होल स्क्वेयर. दिस इज करेंट इनटू रेजिस्टेंस होल स्क्वेयर. ओके, करेंट इनटू रेजिस्टेंस होल स्क्वेयर. सो इफ आई टेक आउट आई नॉट स्क्वेयर कॉमन, आई विल बी ओनली लेफ्ट विथ आर स्क्वेयर प्लस एक्स एल स्क्वेयर. वॉट इज द डिफरेंस? अर्लियर वी जस्ट हैड एक्स एल माइनस एक्स सी, नाउ एक्स सी इज नॉट देयर, ओनली दिस पार्ट इज देयर. So look, I'll again bring this I naught here. So it will be E naught divided by under root R square plus XL square. R square plus XL square. Okay. This will be now, which is the impedance here? I is equal to V by R. What is the resistance? This is the impedance. Simply R square plus XL square. Under root of r square plus xl square. This is the formula which you will be using. And what is z? Z is simply the impedance. Impedance means the resistance of LR circuit. Okay, this is your LR circuit. And if you're calculating cos phi, so cos phi will be the same. See, cos phi will still be the same. Cos phi, the formula of cos phi is already r by z. So this will remain the same. It will here also it will be r by z. Okay. Then we have tan phi. This is simply xl by r. We earlier had xl minus xc by r. Now it will be xl by r or vl by vr. Okay. We'll see a question. First you complete this. Start writing from here. Done.
Yes, ma'am.
All have completed.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so here we have a circuit having only resistor and inductor. So it's based on the topic which we have covered. We have to find out impedance and angle. Angle means the phase difference. So impedance, we have, see what all things we have. We have VR, voltage of the circuit having only resistor. Voltage of the resistance, it is given as 90 volt. What is the voltage of the inductor? It is given as 120 volt.
120.
Please put your pens down and listen, class. Let us discuss it. Then you can copy it, okay? Now, VRMS will be, because we do not have VRMS also. What is the net voltage? So we have studied this will be VR square plus VL square. This is how you will be calculating the VRMS value. Because net voltage is also required for the circuit. Because we are calculating net resistance, impedance is actually the net resistance. Okay, so if you put the value, this is under root 90 square plus 120 square, which is equal to 150 volt. Now we have to find out the impedance. So now impedance is not difficult. See, Z is equal to VRMS by IRMS. VRMS we have calculated 150. IRMS is mentioned in the question as 3 amperes. So this is straight away 50 ohms. Okay, this is the answer for the first part. Second says phase angle. Phase angle, you can use tan phi, you can use cos phi, any value. See, tan phi will be equal to VL divided by VR. Voltage is 120 by 90. So 4, 3. So how do we write it? Phi is equal to tan inverse 4 by 3. Phase and the phase impedance and the phase angle. Z is equal to 50 ohms. Now write it all. Question also. Answer. Okay, now series RC circuit means resistor is there and one capacitor is present. So a resistor, current and voltage are in the same phase. Mariam, you tell me about capacitor. Mariam Mohammed, please open the mic and camera and answer.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, for the series circuit having only capacitor, which is leading
current
or voltage?
Current is leading by 90.
By?
90 degrees.
90 degrees. Very good. So, current is there, voltage is there, and this is pi by 2 VC. Okay, so now this component will be missing. We'll just have VC, right? Now for the derivation also, this is very quick and very easy. See, E naught square will be having R square plus VC square. Sorry, VR, not this. So E naught square is equal to I naught into R whole square plus I naught into XC will come now, whole square. So E naught square is equal to I naught square, R square plus XC whole square. So I naught whole square is equal to E naught whole square divided by R square plus. Yes, Taha, are you there in the class? XC square. So when you take the root, you are left with I naught is equal to E naught divided by root R square plus XC. Z impedance, this is the impedance, it will be under root R square plus XC square. Tan phi will be VC by VR or XC by R. Same. Okay. Please write this as well. So on Tuesday, AC, Tuesday will be the last class for AC, okay? One more class is required after this class that will complete AC. So from the next week, we'll complete EM waves also so that we can start with the second book, okay? I'm starting with transformers because some of the students are having this in their exams. So it will be a revision for them. Transformers, I'm starting. It's a short topic. And we are left with instantaneous power and energy. So nothing is left much in AC. So we'll complete it off in the next class. And if time permits, we'll start with EM waves also. In EM waves also, I'll share a table that we had shared a table in magnetism. And matter. In magnetism and matter, I've shared a table with differences between all the substances. So here also, I'll be sharing you a table, differences between all the waves which are present. There's electromagnetic spectrum, basically whose frequency you have to remember, wavelength you have to remember, their uses you have to remember. So that you have to learn it by yourself. You have to rote learn it. You have to memorize it, okay? That I'll share. And the numerical part, a modified Ampere circuital law and all displacement current that I'll do. Now, what is transformer? Transformer is basically a device that is used to change the voltages. Means current is present. So you have to convert an alternating current from where voltages are differently present. Okay. Now, voltages are differently present, and about the resistance, we have already studied. LCR circuits have their own resistance, impedance. Every circuit has its own resistance. R is there, XL is there, XC is there. So resistances part is also fine. Current part is also fine. But what about the voltage? So some voltages can be high voltages, some can be low. If I say 2000 volt, that will be a high volt. That will be a high voltage. If I say 5 volt, that will be a low voltage. So sometimes devices are there, like your generators, the generators and the transformer machines that are present on roads. These require high voltage, but the supply is very low. The supply of the voltage is very less. So lesser amount of voltage has to be converted into a huge higher amount of voltage. So because of certain applications in our daily life, low voltages are converted into high voltages. And vice versa, when the requirement is of the low voltage, but the supply is very high. So something has to be there that converts these high voltages to low voltages or low to high, depending upon our requirement. These devices are called as the transformer. Okay. So what is a transformer? It is an electrical device for converting an alternating current at low voltage to high voltage or vice versa. Now, if you're converting low to high, Yahya, what it is called?
Step up.
Step up. That's and right. If you're going from high to low?
Step down transformer.
Step down. If you're going from low to high, you just imagine stairs. You step up. And if you're coming down, you step down. Right? So when the voltages are converted from low to high, basically you're increasing the voltage. Then we have step up transformers. And if you are going from low, high to low, these are step down transformers. Okay. Now this basically works on the principle of mutual inductance. Mutual inductance, I'll ask all of you. So write it. And those who do not know, quickly revise it before I ask it. Write it till here. Make the heading transformer. Yes, mutual induction. Yeah, now you remember?
Yes, ma'am. Can I say?
You tell me.
Change in flux in one coil produces current in the neighboring coil.
Produces EMF in the neighboring coil or induces current in the neighboring coil. So that is the principle of mutual induction. Now there are so the principle of this is important. The prince what is the principle of the transformers? It's mutual induction. You know how to explain mutual induction. I'll tell you again. So basically, two types of arrangements are present: core type and the shell type. Now, in core type, what happens? Concentric rectangles are present on one side. The one kind of wire is wrapped around, which is called as the primary coil. And on the other side, the second type of wires are wrapped around, and these are called as the secondary coil. So primary coil and the secondary coil. Okay. Primary coil, in the primary coil, there will be change of flux. Flux will increase or decrease because magnetic field will increase or decrease. Here, induced current and EMF will be produced in this coil. Difference between core type and shell type is that in core type, both are away from each other. In shell type, both are overlapping. In shell type, what happens? In a centralized rod, both the wires are overlapped. One is tight, other one is tight. So they come in contact eventually. So the process is same. Primary will be receiving the change in the flux, and the final one will be, the second one will be inducing, receiving the induced current or EMF. Now, if someone asks you what is the working of a transformer, it's the same as you just have to explain mutual induction. As the alternating current flows through the primary, it generates alternating magnetic flux, which passes through the secondary, means change in the flux in the first. Due to change in magnetic flux, induced EMF will occur in the secondary. Induced EMF will occur in the secondary, means the neighboring coil. Now see, induction, mutual induction is occurring between the two coils. But since the flux is changing, the magnetic field and the magnetic flux is changing in the primary coil, within the primary coil, there will be self-induction. But between both the primary and secondary, it will be mutual induction. So you just have to explain mutual induction and self-induction. That will be the working. So but this is basically an extension of EMI. But since alternating currents are used, that's why it is put as a part of alternating current. Otherwise, this is completely based on EMI. Write it till here, then we'll see the formulas. सी क्लास व्हेन वी हैव द फॉर्मूला फॉर ईएमएफ, ईएमएफ इज इक्वल टू माइनस एन डी फाई ओवर डी टी. सो फॉर द प्राइमरी कॉइल वोल्टेज विल ऑल्सो बी पी, ईएमएफ इज पी एंड नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स पी मीन्स वोल्टेज ऑफ द प्राइमरी कॉइल एंड द नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स ऑफ द प्राइमरी कॉइल. Similarly, E is equal to minus E is equal to minus N d phi over dt from Faraday's law. For secondary coil, this will be it. Voltage across the secondary coil and number of turns across the secondary coil. So when you take the ratio, E S by E P will be equal to N S by N means if secondary is in the numerator, secondary of number of turns will come. If primary is in the numerator, primary will come. Write it till here. Yes, Sufyan, what's the issue? Yes, Sufyan, brief us about transformers, what we have studied in today's class. Adjust the camera properly and answer. At least maintain the decorum. If these people are there in your room, allow them to go out when you're studying for at least 1.5 hours. Adjust the camera properly, Sufyan, and answer. Otherwise, you can directly leave the class. Yes, completed all of you. All right, class, so a small portion of transformers means basically the numerical part is left and power is left. And this is for all of you when you are there in the class. It's an online platform. You're not in a coaching under surveillance, right? So you have to make the decorum by yourself. At least have the doors closed. Do not allow anyone to enter. And even if anyone is there, just concentrate in the class, focus on the class. Okay, this is not just for Sufyan, it's for everyone. And adjust the cameras properly. Siddika, Rishita, Taha, and Yaya have their cameras always properly organized. Okay, so other students also follow this. Sidra, this time the data thing was allowed, but please try to open the camera from the next class. And same thing for you, Khadija. Khadija, in the last class also, you didn't follow the instruction. And Siddiqa and Sidra, I want to ask about your exams. Siddiqa, Sidra, Yahya, you three stay. Rest of you can leave. In the next class, we'll meet. Okay? Yeah, Siddiqa, I just want to ask about your exam. That, when is your exam? Tuesday, you said. Sunday. Yeah, Siddiqa? Am I audible? Yes, Siddiqa, when is your exam? Class test you have, no?
My class test is on Sunday, but my exam is on 28th October.
28th October, the main exam.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
In the class test, only chapter 5th is coming?
Yes, ma'am. Only magnetism.
Okay. Then on Saturday, first, I'll ask you the question, Siddiqa, okay? So that at least you're prepared.
Okay, ma'am.
Or it will be like a revision class only.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay?
It's only derivations.
Only derivations are coming?
For the test. For the test.
The entire chapter must be coming, no?
Yes, ma'am. But for the class test, there's no numericals. I'll have
no
numerical
is coming
the...
in the class test. Okay, I'll just
no,
ask
ma'am.
You the theory part, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, theory part and derivation part. Or I'll just,
okay.
1 hour, we'll just have 1 hour, half an hour, just as to have a good revision so that you perform good in the class test. Further, we'll see the exam later on. And just keep on updating me about your exam also, okay? And please revise.
Okay,
come.
Ma'am.
Okay? Okay, Siddiqa, you can leave.
Thank you.
Okay. Yeah, Sidra, when is your exam? Tuesday. And what is the syllabus, Sidra? First to six chapters. So proper exam, this is your proper exam, numericals, derivation, everything will be coming. So how much are you prepared, Sidra? Third chapter you were telling me, that second and third chapter you're doing. But if six chapters are coming, then on Sunday, Sidra, I'll ask you the question so that it will be just a check for your exam. Or Friday, tomorrow. You have only theory part? How is it possible? Okay, I'll then see the paper also. Tomorrow is not possible. Okay, then Sunday? By Sunday, at least major portion will be done. Because if Tuesday is the exam, by Sunday you have to do it.